Beryl, beryl, beryl is my school. Best education reservoir for young learners just like me. Beryl,
beryl. Hello everybody, grade 4 and grade 5. Nice to be with you again. Good morning and welcome back to our learning, our e-learning. We are continuing today with writing. You remember last week we dwelt on writing too. I think it was 3 weeks ago that we started this lesson. We looked at what writing is, and we looked at what letter writing is, and we looked at the structures of letters. So if you have forgotten, I'm going to do you a little bit to refresh your mind so that before we now enter into the format of writing. Today we are going to dwell on the format of informal letters. But I remember I told you that we have structures of letters or parts of letters. So if you have forgotten, remember that I told you that formal letters have 7 parts. Remember, have 7 parts. Why informal letters have 5 parts. Have 5 parts. Can you remember the parts? Can you remember? All right. Now the parts are, especially this one, we have address. We have address. Address of the writer, the person writing the letter. We have address of the writer. We have the date, date of writing. We have the salutation, salutation, salutation. Then the body of the letter, the body of the letter. Then lastly, the conclusion, conclusion. All right. Now, this is the parts of informal letter. Remember that same last week I told you that 2 parts added to this one, the informal letter. So that you know that whenever you write informal letters, you add that 2 parts. And what are the 2 parts? The 2 parts, you know, the title of the letter, the title, and the recipient address. Now the recipient address is the office of the person you are writing to. The title is what the letter is basically all about. So anytime you are writing informal letter, please remember to add this, to add these 2 parts to this 5 parts. Otherwise, it's the same thing. So, but today we are going to be basically looking at informal letters, and that is the type of letter we write to people who are very close to us. Our loved ones, you know, our mom, our dad, our brother, sister, friend, classmate, you name them, all those people that are very close to you. So we're going to be looking at that type of letter today. So, like I said earlier, today we are going to format of informal letters. Informal letters. So that's going to be our topic today. Now, how do we format this part? That's what the topic is saying. How do we format this 5 part? You just don't write it anyhow. You just don't write it anyhow. You just don't, because it's letter. Each of these 5 parts, they have their position in letter writing, in any informal letter. They have their position. So let me quickly delete that so that you don't start formatting it. All right. So I'm going to delete this one. I'm going to delete this part so that we start formatting our letter. All right. We're going to come to this part of the board. I'm going to assume that from here to this end and from the top to the bottom here is our full stack. So how do we format this letter? Okay. Now, from here to the bottom and from this side to this side is the paper we are using to write. The address is the first thing we're going to do, and the address is at the top right-hand corner. That is where the writer's address is always. That's where it should be, at the top right-hand corner of the paper. That's where the writer's address should be. So, let's assume we are writing from home. From home, we are living at Marian, say, 120 Marian Road. 120 Marian Road. Marian Road. So this is an imaginary letter. So we are feeling, let's assume that we're living there, and that is where we're writing from. So 120 Marian Road, Calabar. The next thing is Cross River State. Now, if the letter is going overseas, we'll put our dear country there, Nigeria. Nigeria will now come at the end. That is where you now put a full stop. Remember that you have to punctuate at the end of every line. At the end of every line. And when you come to the last part of the address, you put a full stop. I hope you're with me. Now, this is just one part of the one type of address. We have two types of address. So we have the block one and we have the slanting one. Let's look at the slanting one. We are going to have something like this, 120 Marian Road. Marian Road. Calabar. Cross River State. Then Nigeria. Put the first stop, punctuate again. All right, look at this. This is the block type. It ends here. And this is the slanted type or indented type. Now, you are free. The choice is all yours. You can do this, you can do this. The problem will be if you start the slanting, then you not end like the block, or if you start the block, you not end like the slanting. That's where the problem will be. So I believe that you can format any of this. If you cannot format this one very well, you can format this. If you cannot do this one very well, you can do this. So you've seen it on the board. This is how it should be. And that is the standard universally, how address of a letter should be. There is not just this. Look at the initial alphabets of every word there. You see that it's all start with capital letters, isn't it? Look at my N in Marian. Look at the R in Road. Look at Calabar there. Look at Cross River State. The three words there all start with capital letters. Look at Nigeria. Now, if you're itching for trouble, if you're looking for trouble, if you dare write Nigeria this way, you'll be penalized, seriously penalized. You'll be punished. Honestly, you'll be punished because this is everything addressed is what we call nouns. Marian is the name of a road. Name of a road in Calabar. Calabar is the name of a city in Nigeria. Cross River State is the name of a state in Nigeria. Of course, Nigeria is the name of a country. So you don't start there with small letters. I'm very, very serious about what I'm telling you. In exam, you now, like some people do, especially girls, they will write Cross River State like this. You are looking for trouble. Honestly, you are looking for trouble. Because this is small S, this is small R, small C. You are looking for trouble, you'll be penalized seriously. There's no two words about it. You'll be punished under structures. You'll be punished. Oh, sorry, mechanical accuracy, you'll be punished. So, this is how it should be. This is how it should be. See, one thing about letter writing I don't know why anybody should run into trouble in an address. I don't know why anybody should run into trouble here in an address. Because if you look at the address, the way it is arranged is very logical. This is 120, that is the street number. And this is the name of the street, Marion Road. And Marion Road is found there in Calabar. That is where Marion Road is found. That's where it is situated, in Calabar. And now, Calabar is where we have Calabar in Cross River State. Can you see how the thing is arranged? And Cross River State is found where? It's only in Nigeria that you have Cross River State. So you arrange your address logically from the immediate place where you are living to the country where you are writing from, if the letter is going overseas. But if the letter is not going overseas, you just simply restrict it to the state where it's coming from, and that's Cross River State. In that case, you remove this full stop here, and you put the full stop here. Are you all with me? You put the full stop here. Because this one will not be there. But since the letter is going overseas, you put Nigeria there. Hope this one is very clear. Hope it is very clear. If there's any problem here, please, as you are submitting the assignment I'm going to give you today, just write the problem and I will try to find a way to solve it. Okay. So that is number one, address. The first thing you do when you write a letter, address of the writer. Address of the writer. That is where you are staying to write or where you are living. Now, if the letter is coming by, if the person you are writing to is going to reply, she or he or she will use this address to reply to you, because that's where you are staying. Now, I don't know the one you can do very well. Is it this one that you like very well, or this one you can do very well? So any of them. Any of them. Okay? Me personally, if I'm writing informal letter, I use this one. But if I'm writing formal letter, I like using this one. Now, I'm not telling you that is the standard. No. That is my own individual idiosyncrasy or individual way of writing. So, any of them, the one you can do very well, please, I advise you to stick to it. Okay, so I'm going to wipe this side. I'm going to wipe this side so that we go to the next thing. Remember that the topic is formats of informal letters. Formats of informal letters. So the number two now is what? Dates. The number two is dates. Now the date will be directly under the address. That's somewhere here. The date will be directly under the address. So, we'll start. What's today? Today is 9. I write my 9 like this. 9 June. And then the year. Alright. Now, in this place too, don't think that the examiner will overlook. You'll be making a very big mistake. A very, very mighty, colossal mistake if you think that this place and this place that the examiner will overlook. You see, this comma is necessary, is important, mandatory that you put your comma after the month. So, look at this one, the TH there. It's necessary, it's mandatory. You put it there. Then at the end of the year, please put a full stop. I hope you are with me. Put a full stop. Now let us look at it closer. I've just told you that these are the way you write your date. The date gives us the information, three information. The day of writing the letter, which is 9. The month of writing, which is June. And the year of writing, which is 2020. Are you all with me? Which is 2020. Alright, now, if you're writing on the 1st, you write it like this. Remember, I told you this some time ago. If you're writing 2nd, you write it like this. If it is on the 3rd, you write it like this. If it is on the foot, you write it like this. Anything down, you put TH. Now, this is simply, this is what we are saying here. You don't have to do this like some people do. This is wrong. Capital offense. Don't do something like this. This place is what? Wrong. It's wrong. Don't do something like that. Okay? This is how you should write it. If it is on the first, you write like that. So what we are saying is this. What's my question? What we are saying is this. When you are spelling first, is it not like this? This is how you spell first. Oh, come on. This is how you spell second, third, and fourth. So what happened here is that you are picking the last two alphabets. Are you with me now? You can see that the last two alphabets is what? ST. The last two alphabets is what? ND. The last two alphabets is what? RD. The last two alphabets is what? TK. So you now add it to the number there. You now add it to the number. Now, if you don't add this TH or ST or ND or RD, what you are saying is that you are counting. What you are saying is, for instance, 9 June 2020. What you are saying is 9 June. You are counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's what you are saying. Until you put this TH before, the person will know that it is on the ninth day of the month of June. Are you getting it now? So please, this place is very, very important. Very, very important. The examiner will look out for this kind of thing. And remember to write the month in full. Remember to write the month in full. All right. Having said that, that is the date. Having said that, we move to the third part of an informal letter. And that is what is the third part? Salutation. 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 What is salutation? Excuse me. What is salutation? Now, I know that you'll give me this popular answer. Salutation is greeting, sir. No, it's not greeting in this situation. Salutation is simply identifying the person you're writing to. That is salutation. Is that okay? When you want to identify the person you're writing to in a letter, we call it salutation. So it's not really greeting. Now, in salutation will not still go under here, but it will go to the left-hand side. Let me quickly point out this. After the address, if the letter is printed, if you are typing the letter, you will skip a line. You skip a line before you come to the date. Are you getting me now? You skip a line before you come to the date. But since you are writing with pen and ink, or pen and whatever, pen and pencil, you don't need to observe that rule of skipping line. You don't need to observe that rule. You just go straight to the next line and then you write your date. So in the same thing, you don't need to skip a line to come to your salutation. So in salutation now, we'll write, who are we writing to? Our classmates. Let's assume we are writing to our classmates. I don't really know your names in that class, so I'm going to guess. Of course, you know that I'm a prophet. I'm going to actually pick a name, and the name should be somebody in that class. there should be a mercy in that class, right? Mercy. Mercy, right? Is there anybody like, okay, let's write a mercy, okay? Mercy. How do you spell your own mercy? Is it M-E like this? Or like this? Which one is in vogue here? Which one is popular here? We go with this. Okay. I'll go with you. So let's use... Alright, so we use this mercy. Man, our marker is not running today. We use this mercy. That's the one we are that's the one that is popular. We are very conversant. We use this mercy. Please, go there with me, okay? Yes, we use this mercy. That's the one we conversant with. We familiar with. So now, this is the salutation. This is what is known as what salutation. Identifying the person you are writing to by his or her first name. Now, we don't know the name, the surname of mercy here, but it is not important here because this person is writing to her friend. Okay? So it is not important here. So you, when you are identifying the person you are writing to by his or her first name, you don't need to put the surname. If you put the surname, you'll be penalized. There's no two ways about it. You'll be punished, you'll be penalized for putting the surname there. You don't need to put the surname there. Okay? So now we have other types of, other ways of saluting people, other ways of identifying people. We have dearest mercy. Dearest mercy. We have my dearest mercy. And we equally have my darling mercy. Alright, we're going to stop there because of my time. So let me explain what all this one stands for. Now, it depends on the degree, it depends on how you are related with this mercy, that you now choose the type of salutation that befits this mercy. Now, if mercy is very dear to you, you'll start using all this one. Now, when you come to this place, you see how I've written it. My, I started it with capital letter, M-Y, my. But this dearest, you don't need to write with capital letter because it's a continuation of that my. But when you come to the person's name, you start the person's name with capital letter, okay? Capital letter. Please, one and 5 minutes to go, you let me know. So you start the person's name with capital letter. Now, like I said, dear mercy is for somebody you are acquainted with. Somebody that you are acquainted with, somebody that you know, you are not too close to the person. But this dearest mercy, you see that intimacy is getting stronger there. You see that before you say somebody is dearest to you, it means that the intimacy is strong. All right. Now, look at this one now. My dearest mercy, the intimacy become, you know, deep, deep, deep down. And then look at this last one, my darling mercy. Say it there to my darling mercy. Now, that is how you identify the person you're writing to. Okay? Now, depending on the intimacy you are having with this person you're writing to, depending on intimacy. Those of you who are very close to your mom, more than your dad, and some of you are very close to dad, more than your mom. So, when you are writing to your mom, to your parent, especially the person that is very close to you, you employ a very good salutation, especially when you are ready to beg for money. You employ a very good salutation so that the person reading this letter, seeing this wonderful salutation, will melt down and say, oh, I'm going to give you that money. Isn't it? Since I'm teaching you how to beg for money. All right. So this is the salutation. It's always at the left hand side. Always at the left hand side, you see this is our address, this is our case. Then you come to the left hand side, then you start the salutation. You start the salutation. When I'm 5 minutes to go, you let me know, mother. So you start the salutation. Now the next thing is the body. If time will permit, the body of the letter. The body. Number four. Remember that we have five parts. Number four is the body. The body of the letter. Good. So the body of the letter is the part, okay? The part that you start giving the details, the reasons why you are writing this letter. All right. I'm not going to bother you so much, but knowing that if it's in a senior class, I will let you know, but I'm going to tell you. Know that the body has three parts to it. The body on its own has three parts. One is the introduction, and the other one is the body proper, and then lastly, the conclusion. Now, the conclusion here is the conclusion of what is in the letter, not the letter itself. Okay, now maybe in the next class, because I don't have time again, in the next class, I'm going to expand this body very well. In other words, I'm going to start from number four to teach to number five. Then I will now go to formatting formal letters. We are formatting informal letters today. We are going to format formal letters. Then let's quickly go to conclusion. Conclusion number five. Conclusion. Now, conclusion is the end of the letter where you sign off. That is where you write your name. Remember that the person you are writing to is messy. Now, it's in the conclusion that you now put your name as the person who wrote this letter after stating what you want from Mercy, the reason for writing to Mercy. You state it there. Now, in the conclusion, you now write your name. Just like we have salutation that we say that salutation depends on the intimacy of the person who writes it to. In conclusion, too, it depends on the intimacy of the person you're writing to. Let's assume you are writing to your friend. Okay, Mercy is your friend, your classmate. So you are going to pick a nice conclusion too. We have so many ways of concluding. We have yours affectionate. Yours affectionate. We have love from yours affectionate. You put your name under. You put your name under. Who is this that's gonna write to Mercy? Let's say Beta. There's a girl Beta. I don't know if it's that girl. Beta. Now it means that yours affectionate Beta. Beta is the person. Now you don't have to put your surname too there. You don't have to put your surname too. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to start summarizing today. I'm moving from here now, because when I come back again next week, I will start from this body, because I didn't say much here. So we are looking at formatting of letters. We have seen the parts of letters, so we are looking at formatting of letters today. Formatting is how you can write it in concrete terms, in the way it should be, that is the standard universally anywhere in the world. So that's what we're looking at. We've seen the address, that we have two types of address. We have the block, we have the slanting. Remember the slanting, and I told you that the choice is all yours. The one that you can format and the one you can format very well, so please stick to it. Now we now look at the date. We said the date gives us three information: the day of writing, the month of writing, and the year of writing. Of course, you've seen it. And I told you that all those alphabet that follows the date, the number, should be written in the same line, okay? Should be written in the same line. And please don't forget to punctuate. All right, having said that, we now go to the salutation. Salutation is the identification of the person we are writing to by his or her first name. And we have various types of salutation, very, very sweet types of salutation, just like this one here. Now, after the salutation, the next thing you do is the body of your letter. And the body is the part that you now give the reason why you are writing this letter. And I equally told you that it's divided into three. The body is structured into three. Next week, when we come back, we'll look at all them. And then lastly, we go to how to summarize, how to conclude your informal order. We say yours affectionate. We have some other one. All right. Stay well. God bless you. Bye-bye.